you should not listen to both. In fact, the best things that have ever been done on this planet always got bad press, largely during their lifetimes, and it was only appreciated after they're gone. In a jungle, we were out on a trek and she broke her hand. I will do in a different way, I'll take the local twigs and tie it up. In our lives, if we do not do what we cannot do, it's not a problem. You must see in the last 25 years, what all accusations and criticisms they've made about me. This is not being done for your appreciation. This is being done because this is my way. The scorpion is doing what it knows best. I am doing what I know best.
Namaskaram Sadhguru, I am Sahiti, final year medico. I would like to know, in our daily life, we come across bipolar situations, like one side we get praised for treating and the other side, in the same moment, if we lose a patient without any due negligence, it's the blame on us. Like, how should we internally fix ourselves, not the perspective of others? How should we internally fix ourselves? Like, should we go with the pain, or should the let guilt eat us, or should we go with this appreciations? Like, how should we cope up with this situation, mainly in our budding stages of our careers?
You should not listen to both.
Be stoned then.
Stoned? Oh, what are you on?
Like, I shouldn't go with the emotional happiness.
No, no, I'll come to that. See, somebody else's opinion becomes important in one's life only when you do not know what you're doing. Yes? If you are very clear about what you're doing, what somebody says, good things or bad things, it doesn't matter. In fact, the best things that have ever been done on this planet always got bad press, largely during their lifetimes, and it was only appreciated after they're gone. Today, the time cycle has changed. It will come back sooner. Appreciation will come back sooner. But you must not be doing things because of appreciation or fear of criticism. You must be doing something that matters to you, isn't it? It really matters to you that right now somebody comes to you with a broken hand. It should matter to you that I want to fix this hand as quickly and as well as I can, with whatever means I have in my hands. If she comes to me when I'm in the orthopedic ward, I will treat her one way. Suppose in a jungle we were out on a trek and she broke her hand, I will do in a different way, I'll take the local twigs and tie it up. All this fancy casing won't be there. But I'm doing my best, that much I know. It may not be the best treatment, but I'm doing my best always. This one thing you fix. Somebody else may come and say, see, the way you fixed this plaster is not good, you should have fixed it that way and this way and this way and that way. Maybe he knows better, but the way I know it, I've done my best. This is all any human being can do, always. But you should not fall short of yourself, isn't it? What you can do must happen. In our lives, if we do not do what we cannot do, it's not a problem. But if we do not do what we can do, we're a disaster, isn't it? So you should not become such a disaster. So if you just stick to this one thing, our people will say many things. You must see in the last 25 years, what all accusations and criticisms they've made about me. The same people, now they're all becoming not just fans, they're becoming devotees. At one time, what kind of abuse daily? Even now there are some people who go on endlessly, endless abuse. people tell me, Sadhguru, how do you listen to all this? I said, just tell me what is the abuse going on because I wish to know. Sadhguru, you should not listen to all this. I said, I want to listen because when you came and threw flowers on me, fell at my feet, personally it doesn't mean a damn thing to me. If it's good for you, you do it. Or when you throw stones at me, it doesn't mean a damn thing to me, okay? Because I'm 100% clear what I'm doing. Maybe you will take time to evolve and appreciate what's happening, but this is not being done for your appreciation. This is being done because this is my way. Let me tell you a little story. A guru was there on the banks of Narmada. One day he went for, you know, the bath was always a dip in the river. So he went for his bath. His disciple was holding his clothes and standing there because otherwise it's muddy if you keep it down. He went in and he saw a scorpion floating down in the water, struggling. A scorpion is not a swimmer, you know. He's struggling. So the guru picked him up. The disciple screamed, "Don't take that scorpion, it'll sting you." Well, the scorpion stung him. The guru slowly walked down, slowly bringing him out. He stung him again and again. The disciple went on screaming, "What are you doing? Just drop the damn thing." The guru walked and let him out on the bank and he went away. And the disciple said, "What kind of rubbish is this? He bit you three times. How much pain is there?" He said, "See, what are you screaming about? The scorpion is doing what it knows best. I am doing what I know best. What are you talking about?" That's all. You're trained to be a doctor, you do your best, somebody says something. Somebody will live, somebody will die. But the question is, are you doing your best? That's all, isn't it? See, the doctors who treated patients 100 years ago, in today's level of medical science, they may look silly and stupid, but they were doing their best. That's all, isn't it? They let a whole lot of people die for small things because that's all they had. But they were doing their best or not is the only question. Because today medicine, science and technology has evolved, all kinds of things could be done. At that time, with what little they had, they did their best. Today also what you're doing may look silly in another 50 years' time. Yes? Yes or no? Medical science will go to places where you being a doctor, what you think is great knowledge may look absurd and silly in 50 years or 100 years' time. Does it mean to say you're a bad doctor? No, you're doing your best. That's all you can do, please do that one thing.